get you sideways.
And a smoker, that's Ronnie Osmer in the 99, a second car for Thomas Prater, and that brings out our first caution. And then we've got more problems in turn number four. Andy Seiss has gone around in the 02 car.
That's the 52 of Will Rogers right there in front of your screen, the Dryden car. That's the same car that Austin won the championship with last year.
Oh, and he was having such a good run. He had moved up about 15 spots. Cody Robaugh in the number seven, Grant Kelly.
Void the 99. Let's see what happens here. That's the leaders going by that 99. You see the 27 of Travis Brayton go down on the inside.
There's Robaugh up above him, and he gets by. And that 52 car.
Andy Seiss actually looks like he was coming down to try to get back in line on the bottom, and they may have made contact there. That's where they've already got into each other.
So something happened after they got by the 99.
Yeah, and I think Will Rogers in the 52 was just an innocent victim there with nowhere to go.
Two cars going for the same real estate.
Let's see if we can see anything on board with Gus Dean.
Watch Andy Seiss in the 02 as they get by this 99 car.
There you go. There's the first contact.
Didn't look like Andy knew that the car was beneath him. Kept coming down.
Does he have damage? He's not going to have the lead. We go back to green from Daytona International in ARCA. Let's watch again.
See, that's the crew chief's job for the 41 of Zane Smith to know who's pitting around you. He knew that Bobby Gerhart was coming in the pits, and he sent Zane in the 41. Bobby had to turn down and
try to find out what happened.
Looks like they just get seized up. Looks like the 63 of Dave Mader the third gets into the back of the 33 and turns him around. That's what's going to send him to the outside wall. They just kind of got bottled up a little bit on the inside, it looked like. And the farther back you go, the less time you have to react.
This on board with Natalie Decker.
Checked up.
Amazing. What a great job she did. You could hear her get out of the throttle. She had hardly any time to react.
That's impressive.
It certainly was. Pretty hard contact with the outside safer barrier for Saxton.
And what we saw from Natalie Decker, who's had a fast car, that's the detriment. That's one of the things that happens when you fall further back in the field, running in the 20. She's 22nd right now.
Yeah, these guys were trying to avoid her as they got by the incident. You see a lot of damage to Ed Pompa's car as he makes contact with Andrew Belmont.
Is in trouble. Let's look back to the restart.
See right behind Max Tolman. You see Max is going to run into the back of Bobby Gerhart. Natalie's going to do the same thing, the accordion effect, and look how much damage it did to Natalie's car.
Two big time contenders. Tolman was restarting 20th, Decker in 21st.
They just didn't go. Barrier in the 46 car. That may cost this group the draft.
They've got some work to do to catch up to the lead pack.
Well, there we
go. Huge wreck.
Core, Half, Lamastis, and Doza all involved. Semi big one here at Daytona, caution number four.
The 98 of Half just didn't give him enough room.
Guys, we saw that coming from mile
three on the top side with a good push from Purdy. They're wrecking. Holmes is going around and upside down. Zane Smith around. A big one here at Daytona, but keep in mind, this is not the finish of this race. We will see a one-lap shootout to determine this one. So another restart coming. And that's Holmes on his side. Thompson also comes to a stop, and multiple cars involved here on the final lap at Daytona. Look at how all of this got started. Look at the 23 on the bottom side of Holmes.
See that we've got the 18 pushing the 32, and the 32 is trying to help the 23, but he catches him in the right rear corner, and that turns him sideways. And I think he launched off the front of the 66 of Mark Thompson.
If it wouldn't have been for that incident, the outside line definitely would have had a shot at the win.
And I think you guys might be right. Sean Core is being shown on our scoring monitor in second, and he's lined up second under this red flag.
See, look at the momentum the outside lane had before that.
I'm not sure, though. It depends on.
Remember, it's not instantaneous. I mean, it's not, you know, the caution flag's going to come out as soon as they can, because they know the damage is severe enough that we need a caution flag, as you see Brett Holmes sliding down driver's side.
That's going to be close, because Core definitely had the momentum, and it was on his way. From that angle, it looks like he is ahead of
it. Does.
I think Gregson.
So. Yeah. Yeah, sure does.
And then Purdy is up there. Yeah. And Zane Smith almost was ahead of it, and he got hit on the rear quarter.
Yeah, Dave Mader the third made hard contact with Zane Smith. Dave Mader was doing a nice job. We haven't talked a whole lot about him. He's a former winner here in the series back in, what, 91?
Correct.
He won a race at Michigan. He was a Snowball Derby winner in 1978.
On board with Gus Dean.
Trying to pedal the throttle to try to get out from that situation.
Riley Herb just had a few close calls tonight.
Both those cars in front of him involved in the incident. Let's see how Riley gets through here.
Looks like he takes a wild ride through the grass.
He dodged two of them. Didn't spend too much time on the grass, though.
Did a great job. This is going to be a great view right here. Look at everybody going down to the grass. That's Thomas Prater, that yellow and black car that went through the grass a little bit. And then we saw Riley Herbst go through the grass. Let's see who gets the advantage going in three.
Creed on the bottom side.
Big
Purdy is going around hard into the wall. Car goes with him. Caution. And we'll try again.
Michael Self, Willie Mullins are the first two cars to get through there.
Riley Herbst also involved.
A lot of cars involved in that incident.
All right, let's see what happened here. Creed on the bottom, Core on the top.
Nobody to blame here. These guys are just doing all they can do to be pushed. You see the 28 get pushed sideways, and then the 43 of Core and the 8 of Chase Purdy make contact. The 43 takes the 27 up into the outside wall. You see Michael Self go by relatively unscathed from this incident anyway.
Chase Purdy got tight on the bottom. You could see he didn't have any air on his nose, and he just couldn't keep it down there and got into the outside lane.
He didn't have any air on his nose because his nose was up underneath the back of the 28
car. And you have to do that if you want to win the race, but you can see it here.
This is on the middle of the back stretch.
Bumper to bumper, gets tight.
You can see how much higher his nose was there with no air on it.
And once cars get together, it's over.
Higher is the 06 and the 9. There's Brad Smith making contact with the 06. There's Riley Herbst, the NOS car on the right.
I think we're going to need to count the cars that haven't made contact.
Yeah, exactly. As Travis Braden's on board. Nowhere to go. Absolutely nowhere to go.
On board with Natalie Decker.
She gets a good job. I'm sure Eddie DeHaan, her spotter, is talking her through this. She gets through on the bottom now. Looks like the track's blocked in front of her. Brad Smith's going to go down there, pass her, and hit
she
somebody.
She still did a good job getting through
What
there.
An amazing job she did getting through that. Looks like maybe at the very instant she might have got hit from behind.
So this is Riley Herbst on board with his. He's had one of many that's had an eventful night. Just about everyone has.
He was going to be okay till Brad Smith ran into the 06.
This might give us a better look at Shelton Creed. Yeah. Almost got out of the car, tried to hang on to the spin, and then presumed just went through the grass.
Yeah, spins down through the grass. If he kept that car going, though, and kept it rolling, and is going to restart in the fourth position, then he still has a shot at this.
This might give us a better look at Shelton Creed in the 28 United Rentals car. And gets it turned back.
And up in front of Noah Gregson. Right now, our scoring monitor shows Noah Gregson. Depends if ARCA deems that he was maintaining speed and when the caution flag came out. Look at the damage. The 06 into the windshield of Riley Herbst.
As a former car owner, how much are you thinking when you see these?
Oh,
how expensive
just
this is.
Dollar signs.
Oh.
Just dollar signs. I mean, after the fact, you think about trying to get that trophy first.
Yeah. And then second, you're making sure that the driver is safe.
Exactly.
But after that, it's.